They say you're a product of your environment, that where you come from defines who you are. But here, you get to write your own story, a story of resilience, strength, and sisterhood. When you step onto this field, you're not just joining a team, you're stepping into a family. This isn't just about football. It's about learning to fight, to stand tall, and to believe in your own potential. It's about discovering what you're capable of, building a bond that runs deeper than the game, and seeing just how far we can go together.
Growing up, I was an athlete and I had great relationships with my coaches. There was good moments, there was bad moments, but knowing that I was put into a position of influence, I wanted to recreate that for my athletes, make sure they knew they had someone in their corner. Again, we've seen good moments, we've seen bad moments, we've cried tears, we've laughed laughs. So my goal is always, obviously, development on the field, but also just them as people, the family that they created, the network, and then just building their skills as individuals to know, like, I can do hard things, not just athletically, academically, amongst people within the communities.
You guys make an impact whether you believe it or not. And so that's why I am always on you guys, always, right? The name on your jersey, how we walk around school, what people hear, your voices, the way you talk. But there is a reason. My expectation for you guys is up here because that's what I see in you guys.
I would say our coach, she really, like Kennedy said, she poured a lot into us. Talks after every game, like, when she yelled at us, that really make us lock in. Words of encouragement.
She do everything she can for us. She wants us to succeed in, like, as most as we can. She want all of us to go to college. She's very, like, she just pour into us as much as she can. Like, she want all of us to do good. Like, so yeah, it's just like an extra boost of like confidence. Like, if she, if our coach believe in us, then I believe in us too.
Playoff flag football means history here at Lakewood as the Lancers finished the season 8-5 and second in the Moore League in their second year. Definitely on the uptrend.
How we grew this year is just so incredible. Like we're all just here as a team, we're here to play. And last year, it was a lot of girls who was just here just for that grade. Wasn't really here to play and give it their all. So I'm really grateful.
Everybody look at us like Lakewood, or everybody has their own image about our team. But I feel like everybody should just know, like, we competitors. We just like everybody else. We no different. We go as hard. We as confident and just as good as everybody else.
Now that we made CIF, you know, we got the band coming out. Stuff that we really been should have had. So we worked our way up here, and I'm proud of us.
I feel good. I'm ready. Bring it on. Be ready. I'm feeling good. I'm feeling confident. I'm not nervous at all. I'm just really ready to play.
I'm really a leader, and I really have to lead this team to victory. And if I don't, then dang. I mean, that's it. Next year. But my goal is to lead this team in the right way, because they all trust me. They all listen to me. So I might as well take that for granted and, you know, give it my best on the field.
Sometimes in life, there are moments. Moments where you know, without a doubt, that you're exactly where you're meant to be. You can feel it. Every ounce of preparation, every late night, every sacrifice, it's all led to this. Now, it's just a matter of reaching out and taking hold of what's been waiting for you all along.
Bradley chucks the ball almost 40 yards down the field, and Nyima King answers. Lakewood wins their first ever flag football playoff game, 18-12 at home, to make history here for these girls, and they're definitely hyped up.
history was made tonight.
Your pump up music, whatever you use, you need to use it, because life is gonna life, but God is gonna God, and you'll be able to get through anything.
When it's all said and done, I hope that the girls, first and foremost, remember their strength, their light, all of their greatness within, no matter what obstacles happen in their life moving forward. Life is gonna life, but also God has granted them so many traits and qualities that are hard to come by, and I hope that they hold on to those. I hope that they also understand how they have stepped up as women in leadership to lead for generations to come. We're a two-year program, and they have already set the precedence for the next year. And just taking that with them, like, you are a leader, you do shine bright. Everything that you do, like, put 110, 150% into it, because the outcome will speak for itself. And just to ignore the outside world, like, I know we're in a public school, but God has purposed these young women for great things, and I hope that they take that with them and they remember that forever.
At the end of the day, sports are about more than wins and losses. It's about faith, believing in something bigger, trusting your strength, and finding courage in moments of doubt. Because in the end, it's not the scoreboard that defines you, it's the story you write, the lives you touch, and the legacy you leave behind. So, the question is, what story will you choose to write?
Because it's like my third year on the team, and this is our first time doing this. I'm proud of us. We never did this before, so like, for us to be here, it's fun.
Sing.
I am amazing.
I am a warrior.
I am a warrior.
I am a winner.
I am a winner.
I am victorious.
I am victorious.
I can do anything.
I can do anything.
I put my mind to it. If I say I can't,
I can't.
I can't. But if I say I can't,
I can and I will.
Girl, you're working with some passion.